EFF has commented on a Bella bill. Well, guys, we are about to go through that. Please wait for me. MK Party has commented on Ramaphosa as well as the Minister of Education, Ukwarube, who was not available, who was not there as the bill was signed. MK Party has got something to say about DA Ramaphosa and the Minister of Education. So, where do you want me to start? Definitely, I think I need to start from the EFF and then I will end with the MK Party, right? So, the Bella Bill has been signed today. Ramaphosa signed the Bella Bill, and in a ceremony as per the planning, the ceremony went as follows.
Okay.
Colleagues in front that are taking pictures, please be considerate of your colleagues at the back. Thank you.
Okay, here we go.
You don't look happy. It's not a picture, Excellency, if you're standing with the bill.
You implement immediately the other two in 3 months. Yeah. That's it. Yes. Thank you.
Okay, so moving right along, EFF then has commented on a statement that was released on the 13th of September 2023. The statement says the Economic Freedom Fighter EFF notes that President Ramaphosa has signed the Basic Education Laws Amendment Bella Bill into law. We welcome this development and recognize the progressive nature of the act in enacting legislative amendment to standardize public basic education in South Africa. But then they went on to say the following. Wait, paragraph 2. The various provision made in this bill has been created to bring the administration of basic education in line with the development that have taken place over the past decade. The EFF welcomes the amendment of the South African Schools Act, which seeks to make education compulsory from grade R to grade 12. And we endorse the criminalization of anyone who unjustly prevent children from attending school. So right there, the Bella Bill is a bit explained by the statement of EFF. So yeah, I thought to myself, let me take you through. Mind you, MK Party has not yet spoken, so you will need to hear what MK Party has got to say. But you best believe me, they came from a different angle, and I'm gonna tell you what that angle is. Right? But before I can do so successfully, I'm going to require you to do this. If you are not yet subscribed, what are you waiting for? Come on, good people. Because to subscribe, it is free. To like the video, it is free. To comment in the comment section below, it is free of charge. To click the notification bell, it is free of charge. To share this video, it is free of charge. To watch this video until the end, it is free of charge. Also, good people, I mean, come on, to watch the ads, it's free of charge, and that's how you financially contribute to this YouTube channel. Speaking about financially contributing to the channel, you can join, become a member of this YouTube channel from as little as 20 rand a month. You can also use the Super Thanks button. In case you don't want to do that, guys, there is a way where you can use my media company banking details to donate to the channel, and you know what I'm saying? Will bring you more, and also guys want to buy more equipment. So the power is in your hands. Please do the honorable thing as we proceed. Okay, yeah, so let's move on now. The next paragraph says, In particular, we support the provision that grant principal more authority to monitor schools' attendance and take action if a pupil whereabout are unknown after 24 hours of non-attendance. The measure aimed to curb the high dropout rates, and principals at school and schools governing bodies, SGBs, are empowered to investigate the reasons behind the absenteeism. Another paragraph says, however, we are flabbergasted by Ramaphosa's capitulation to the bullying from his right-wing coalition partner, the Democratic Alliance, by postponing the implementation of clauses 4 and 5, the bill for three months for further consultation. These clauses relate to the admission and language policies at school. We give head of department instead of school governing bodies the final authority on admission and language policy in school. This is where the problem starts. They are saying DA got involved and went to the president and said, President, you can't do this. You know what I'm saying? Why? Because they wanna protect Afrikaans by all means necessary. Mind you, MK Party has not yet spoken. We're just still dealing with the EFF. So allow me to proceed. As we proceed, the next paragraph says, this power left to the SGB alone has perpetuated forbid racist policies and attitude to find expression at school, and has been used by SGBs to use language as a means of excluding predominantly African children from public schools that were previously exclusively reserved for white. The next paragraph says, this blatant disregard for the process that we followed by Parliament, which entailed a thorough, extensive process of public participation. The right-wing element that Ramaphosa seeks to appease had ample opportunity to participate in this participation process, and many of them did actually participate. Parliament rightfully refused to be held at ransom by these racist entitled and processed the bill accordingly. Okay. The next paragraph says, Ramaphosa's actions today are equivalent of him showing the meekly finger to his parliamentary process. Additionally, Ramaphosa also does something much more heinous, through his decision today. He affirms the right of races to dictate and continue to include enrollment of African people and the public schools that these races thinks they are exclusively theirs. The next paragraph says, their opposition to the bill is not merely about preservation of Afrikaans as a language. It is about continued entrenchment of Afrikanerdom power, whose continued inexistence directly that correlate with the continued subjugation, the other word, I can't even see what's that, an exclusion of African people. He has confirmed white power and condemned black aspiration even further. Whites needs not to be in power with people like Ramaphosa around. Oh, my God. Yeah. Yeah. Maybe I should reserve my comment. Only comment once we go through MK Party and hear what MK Party has got to say. MK Party has got this to say. MK Party Youth League strongly condemns both disgraceful absence of basic education minister Siviwe Gwarube at the signing of the Basic Education Laws Amendment Bill, the Bella Bill, and President Ramaphosa's delay of clause 4 and 5. Minister Guadalupe's failure to attend this critical moment of for black South African is a clear sign of betrayal. As a young black leader, she has chosen to serve her white handlers who perpetuate an anti-black agenda instead of uplifting their own people. EFF, together with MK Pat, are singing on the same hymn there. What's your take? The next paragraph says, her action shows she is ashamed of her blackness, refusing to support and fight for transformative policies that will empower black children and communities. The delay in implementing Clause 4 and 5, which are key of dismantling the protection of Afrikaans language privilege in a public school, is another coward attempt to placate with white interest. Ramaphosa's decision to delay these clauses by 3 months only benefit those who want to maintain exclusivity in schools and preserve Afrikaans as a gatekeeper of privilege. As black South Africans, we must reject Minister Guarube and any leader who align themselves with the oppressors. The next paragraph says, MK Party Youth League declares that the government of national unity is crumbling and we welcome the collapse of the coalition built on deceit and betrayal. The DA threats to leave over a progressive bill that will support black South Africans exposes their true intentions. The time for transformation is now, and we will not be held back by leaders who refuse to stand for our people. The last paragraph says, MK Party Youth League calls for the immediate implementation of these clauses and condemns any delay as betrayal of black South Africans. This is not the time for half measure. We must fight for education system that reflects the demographics and diversity of our country. We refuse to let Ramaphosa's abasement of white interest stand in the way of true transformation. Coming back with more. I can say that just looking at this, honestly, I think that the EFF and as well as the MK Party, they sing from the same hymnal. They see things the same way, which is good. They see things the same way. They are both concerned about the same thing. There's nothing much to say except also to acknowledge the fact that I have not studied the Bella Bill. I don't want to lie to you and say or pretend as if I understand the Bella Bill thoroughly. I honestly am as clueless as many of you guys. Well, some of you guys are clued up, but me and the others, we are clueless. So I think it will take a bit of an education for people to take us through and show us why we should believe in the Bella Bill. You know what I'm saying? I think it will take us through. It will lead us into that proper understanding as to why it is important. The Bella Bill is important. Because I can't advocate for something that I'm just... Because I've heard people there and there, you know what I'm saying? But I can't advocate for something that I strongly don't understand what is it all about. Just because of snippet, 30 seconds... videos or 30 seconds of explanation there and there, and then I think that look, and then I can conclude that I fully understand the Bella Bill. I know what it stands for. I cannot, not even for a moment, I cannot really advocate for that, because I don't know what it stands for. Do you know? Maybe also it would be nice. I think I'll take my time. I'll take my time. I'll give myself time to study this thing so I can understand, but I think it would be late. Eh? You guys will not be interested anymore. But I'll do it for the sake of understanding things, right? Because it's also nice to understand how things are done. So when you comment, the next time you comment about the Bella Bill, I'm talking about myself. The next time I comment about the Bella Bill, I know exactly what I'm talking about. I know exactly what it means. As of now, I'm just as clueless as everybody. I just wish there were some videos where somebody went deeper and explained it thorough. What is it? And if I had time, basically, it's just that I'm sick. If I had time, I would have done that. I would have gone through, studied the Bella Bill, understand each and everything that are being said in the Bella Bill. Then again, we'll have a nice conversation, because it was once hinted at some point by in one of my show, the debate show. It was once hinted that hey, there's this thing called Bella Bill, which is got this and this and this element. At the time, I just didn't take it serious. You know what I'm saying? I don't wanna lie. I didn't take it serious. But now that it has been signed, now I'm like, wow, Bella Bill is here. But again, what can we say? It's already been signed, guys. I think it would be nice for me and you to meet in the comment section below. So I will see you guys on the next episode.